Hello, everybody. My name is John Armstrong. I'm a professor of physics here at Weber State University, and I'm also one of the instructors for Physics for Scientists and Engineers. And today I wanted to give a brief introduction to Excel, a spreadsheet we'll be using for numerical work in class and also for a lot of data analysis in the lab for this course. So I thought we would get started just learning how to use Excel by creating a gradebook, basically a grade computation tool that allows you to track your performance in this class. Just why don't I close this and we'll start fresh here. If I just fire up Excel, you'll get something that looks like this, which is our template display. And you can see there's a bunch of stuff in here that we could mess around with. But we'll start with a blank worksheet. And this is our blank workbook. So a workbook is the overall structure, and it's separated into sheets, and these sheets can be named. So I'm going to call this my grade summary. This is just the first sheet that I have, and I can add more sheets, and I may want to add sheets maybe for assignments, maybe for the exams. We're going to come back to that in a second. We're going to start with the grade summary, and these are cells, and they're organized in a two-dimensional grid. You can find any cell by designating its column and row. This is row 7, column A. This is column H, row 5. A spreadsheet is simply arrays of two-dimensional data. So what sort of data do we have in our course gradebook that we would like to display? The first thing is going to be the category of the grade. And if I go and look at the syllabus for my course, I find that I have effectively five categories. Now, this might differ if you have a different instructor than me, but go make sure you check your resource or your syllabus. But I have reading discussions. We have assignments. Those are our normal homework assignments. We have exams. We have lab, and lab is broken up into two categories, which is the lab and the lab final. I'm going to go ahead and bold this category description just so that it's easier to see that we have, this is the title. And the categories, each category has a particular weight. So I'm going to call this the weight. The weights are 10%, 30%, 40%, 17%, and 3%. Now, I would like that to look as percentage. Those are just numbers there. I would like these to be percent. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight these. And then if I come under my formatting toolbar up here, I can select a percent. And if I click percent, oh no, it's 1,000%, 3,000%. So I need to go back in here and remember that 10% is really 0.1. And 30% is really 0.3. And 40% is really 0.4. And 17% is really 0.17, and 3% is really 0.03%. And then I don't really need these types of high precision numbers, so I'm going to go ahead and highlight those. And then underneath my formatting tab up here, I have places where I can either increase the precision or decrease the precision. And I'm just going to leave that there at basically two significant figures. Okay, so that's the category, that's the weight, and then finally I have my score. I'm going to go ahead and bold that again. And of course, we don't know what these are yet, so I'm going to go ahead and say that my score in all of these things is 100. We can come back and fill those in. So now, once I have that, I can calculate my final score by applying all of these weights to each of these categories. So in here, to do a function, I'm going to press the equal sign. That's going to give me a function. And then what I want to do is do a weighted average of all of these scores, which means I'm going to take the first score and multiply it by the weight. And then I'm going to add to that the second score multiplied by its weight. And then I'm going to add to that the third score multiplied by its weight, and add to that the fourth score, and so on, to give me the weighted average. Now, the total weights of these is just going to be the sum of these guys. So I'm going to go ahead and do the sum. The total weight in the course is 100%, so we want that to be like that, and we can look at our our function up here. And if I click on that, it shows all of the things that I've got there. So I'm going to go ahead and hit return, and I've got 100. Now you can see that as I get different things on these weightings, I can change my grade. So let's say, for example, and that shows you that your final score is going to be 88.08. So you can kind of, you know, you could ask yourself, well, how well do I expect to do on various aspects of the course? It'll automatically give you what the grade is. I just want to write another category here called projections. Or let's say, maybe we should say goals. So our goals here, I mean, ideally, I'd like to get 100% in everything. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I just copied those cells down by just clicking the bottom corner there. And I can get this the category in here. I'd like to be able to do the same calculation with this over here, except I have to change it just a little bit because I want to use these goals here, but I want to use these weights here. So let's see how we can make it so it preserves the weights, but uses different numbers. So I'm going to go in here and I can see that all of the B columns are my weights and I want those to stay exactly the same. So I'm going to put a dollar sign in front of each one of those numbers and letters in the B column. Now what this does is it basically says, make sure that when you do this calculation, you always use B2, no matter where in the worksheet I happen to have this cell. So if I go ahead and do that, I see I've changed nothing, but now I can just grab the corner of this and drag it over to the right, and it copies the same formula, but it changes column C to column D, but it leaves the column B intact. Okay, so that gets our categories going. Now let's make it so we can track our actual performance. So to track our performance, we're going to need ideally a couple of different ways to organize the data that we have coming in. So I'm going to make another spreadsheet. I'm going to call this reading discussions. And we'll have lab final and the lab scores, just because it seems cleaner that way. So our reading discussions, we know we have the discussions in this class. 1, 2, we have 14 of these things. Now I just put 1 and 2. If I highlight that, I can go ahead and copy that down and it'll automatically fill into 14. Whoop, there you go. And then you can put score here, maybe bold those things so that we have, maybe bold that so it looks like a category. We're gonna need to have the sum, or I should say the total, and then the score. So the total, if each one of these is worth 10 points, you know, we can say 8, 9, 10, 7, 5, etc. The total is just going to be equal to the sum of those. And the score is going to be, basically we need to get this out of 100 for it to fit on our score sheet. So the score is going to be the sum divided by the count of all of these. And if I look at that, that's going to be a number out of 10, because these are all out of 10 and we need something that's out of 100. So I'm going to multiply that by 10. So that means you're going to get 78 out of that. The total score is there. So let's just check this. If I put in a 10 everywhere, then I should get a total score of 140 and a total score of 100. Okay, that works. And then I can go ahead and make those blank. And now this is prepared to give us the score, which currently says divide by 0 because we don't have anything in there. I can do the same thing with the assignment. And then the last thing you're going to have here is your lab final, which will just be a score 0 out of 100. So that's something we can fill in a little bit later. Now, as you're going along in your grade summary, it'd be nice if your scores were reflective of what you added in here. So let's go ahead and do that. So your score here is going to be the score for each one of these things. So I'm going to put in an equal sign, and then I'm going to select the sheet in question, and I'm going to select the score and hit return. And it's going to say divide by zero because we have nothing in there. I'm going to do that for assignments, lab final, which is just going to be that right there. Okay. Now, as we begin to populate this thing, because we have the count in here, we have the sum and we have the count, it's going to keep a running total of your scores. So let's say you do the first reading discussion, you get a 10. That gives you a score of 100 because you have completed 100% of the discussions and gotten 100% on those. Your first assignment, let's say you get a 95 or you get a 9.5. That's going to give you a 95. We get to the first exam and you get, let's say, a 90. Whoops, we got a little error here. Guess these are, the exams are always out of 100. So I'm going to get rid of the 10 there. There we go. And for the labs, let's say you do the first few labs, you get a 9.8, you get a 9.5, you get an 8.0. And we can see the running tally down here. So far, we have nothing for the lab final, so we put 0 there. And if we go back here, we can see that your grade summary now has your final score, your grade, reflective of what your current scores are on what you've already completed. Okay, so I think we're going to leave it at that. That's a very simple grade calculator. There's lots of other things you could do with this. You can, if you'd like, you can import the grade scale so that you can show that this is, you know, what letter grade this would be. And that's something that you can do with a few test statements that are a little bit more sophisticated that we'll get to as we go further along. But if you can complete something like this, I think you'll have a tool to keep track of your progress and make sure you do well in the class as well as learn some Excel skills. All right, we'll see you later.